Barzakh is a place that is liminal in my practice, and it's something that is reinvestigated over and over because it's something that is a contemporary idea of liminality. Liminality nowadays is a contemporary issue and discourse that many Muslim women specifically reinvestigate over and over again because it's a space to reinvestigate feminism and contemporary feminism. And my work hasn't been called feminist in the past, but right now my discourse is feminist because I'm the subject matter of my work. The process in my work is split into two sections. One section would be the reading and the writing, and then the making, which is the output of these two sections. My reading practice, I would say, revolves around reading a lot about Islamic thoughts and theories, specifically targeted with Sufism. One book would be Cyrus Ali Zargar's The Polished Mirror, where he reintroduces many prominent Sufi philosophers or Sufi disciplined philosophers such as Avicenna. They talk about the faculty of the soul, and when I read that, I was very compelled because I wasn't exposed to that back home, or at least in Kuwait. The way we learned about religion was very almost like linear, or it was made as if it was like a single glove that would fit everyone. And I wanted to reinvestigate my faith and my spirituality, and through reading, I have found that, and I have embarked on a new journey, and now I wanna take that reading and put it into the writing. So my writing is very poetic, it's very personal as well, and it includes my subjective experiences with like Islamophobia in the West and the Western body and the feminist Muslima body that lives in the West and that lives in the East and the in-between. It bleeds into the canvas, and the canvas becomes like almost a theory or a hypothesis, and it breathes and it escalates from one contradiction to another. And I mean contradiction, I mean opposing forces, positive opposing forces. And at the same time, that process is even more elevated through gesture, through the idea of leakage in my work, through layering, and at the same time through ornamentation and the figure. In my piece called Menzil, my initial response was to create a domestic rug and a prayer rug. I wanted to converge both of these elements and bring the idea of the public and the private together. And my initial also intention was to almost birth the Muslima or my own body in a space that is accessible in logic, and it's also inaccessible because of one's own censorship as well. I wanted to test my censorship. So that prayer rug, technically the viewer can step on it, but they will not feel comfortable to step on it. And the reason why I invite that and I welcome that was because I wanted the narrative or the image to be erased by the viewer's footsteps. But the viewer might not feel comfortable, and that to me triggered like another response to this piece, which is when we revolve around this carpet piece, what are we replicating? What kind of motion does it evoke? It reminded me almost about the motion of the Kaaba. It's not the Kaaba, but the thing is, it's something that is moving in circular motion. It's fluctuant. It was, so initially that rug was made of two components. One, it was something that is made out of homesickness. I wanted to replicate the sensation of being in my room back in Kuwait and having the mosque sound bleeding into my room. And that's why there's almost a mosque structure being in the middle, and there are two figures conversing with one another in that graphite realm. At the same time, the figures that are layered, the sculptures on top and the fabrics, are contemporary and present existences of me being in that liminal space. That's why the figures do not have faces. That's why some of the faces are cut out. They replicate the Muslima that is living in that third space, and I wanted to converse with my body being in different temporalities. Also, the idea of having people walk on top of it, that was something when I created the piece I wasn't aware of completely. I did not think that people would feel like they're invading one's privacy or almost feeling like they're transgressing the space. However, there was only one person that wanted to walk on that carpet, and that person was from the Middle East, and a Westerner would not understand that. I'm a practicing artist from Kuwait, and I've been in New York City for the past 7 years. I got my bachelor's degree in fine arts in the School of Visual Arts, and I received my MFA from Parsons in fine arts as well. I have been in this city for as long as I could remember. My work grew up here, and I'm always in between the West and the East. And at the same time, I established this third space that is not under these two cultural connotations. I'm forming my own culture, and I'm speaking about a contemporary existence of many Muslims and as a feminist Arab woman.